When you think about the constraints on a Sudoku grid, and I obviously there's the famous one, you've got to have 1 to 9 in these rows, columns, and but this is another constraint on a Sudoku. It's amazing that so many are possible. It's amazing they can make so many different ones.
The world of Sudoku, it's almost a sort of bottomless pit. We've just done the Fistamafel ring, and we saw how sets of different digits can be important. I'm going to show you something mad now, which is where Sudoku constructors have taken this sort of thinking. I don't know if you can see this grid here, but there's a few things to know about the rules of Sudoku as they apply in this grid. So you can see there are some cages in the grid. So the digits in this cage have to sum to y to the power of 2. The digits in this cage have to sum to x to the power 2. And the only other thing you really need to know is that these arrows with circles, the digits along the arrow have to sum up to the digit in the circle. So if this was a 1 and this was a 2, this would be equal to 3. This puzzle involved trying to work out what x and y were. And using the Fistamafel ring and the ideas of set theory, you can work it out. And that's what I'll try and show you now.
It also has to obey the normal Sudoku rules of the columns, the rows, and the squares.
Yes, it does. It does indeed. Let me start. So this time, we're going to highlight the first 4 rows of the grid using the red pen. And again, we know that the red cells are 4 sets of the digits 1 to 9 altogether. And now our green cells this time are not going to be quite the same. So I'm going to highlight 5 complete columns. So in this instance, we've got 4 sets of the digits 1 to 9 in the red cells and 5 sets of the digits 1 to 9 in the green columns. And we can see, if we look carefully again, let's use my blue pen, this portion of the grid has 2 colours in every cell. So we can remove all of these from both sets, and we know that the difference between the red set of tiles and the green set of tiles is still 1 set of the digits 1 to 9, because we had 4 sets versus 5 sets. We've removed the same thing from both, so the difference is still 1 set of the digits 1 to 9. I want to imagine that we remove this box 1, this box here, from the red set. So now, what's the difference between the red tiles we've got remaining and the green tiles we've got remaining? It's now 2 sets of the digits 1 to 9. So we're going into mad lands now. But we can actually use this to solve this puzzle, because what we've got remaining in red is just this cage, which we know sums to y to the power of 2. And what we've got left in the bottom of the grid is all of those squares. So it's all of these squares versus this cage, the difference is 2 sets of the digits 1 to 9. And this is where constructors get even more crazy, because they say, okay, well, what would happen if we equalized those differences? So what we could do is add the whole of column 9 into red. And what we could do is add the whole of row 9 into red. And if we did that, this cell is obviously twice in red now, this cell here. But if we do that, red and green are now equivalent again, because we've added one more complete set of red into the red set, and another complete row of the Sudokus, that's another complete set of the digits 1 to 9 into the red set. So at the moment, the red and the green are now equivalent. And now you can play some games to isolate this cage, which hopefully you can see is x to the power of 2. And the way that you do that is you take out, just as we did before, you take out the cells from both sets that are common, which is this one, 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 and this one. And if you look very carefully now, you can see that these arrows, which have to add up to the same number, these 2 digits here sum up to the same as a digit in the green set. So if we were to take these 2 digits out of red and take this digit out of green, the set still should sum to the same number. We can take these 2 out and knock this one out. And look at what we're left in the corner. We've got this cell here, which was twice in red and once in green. So if we cancel that once from red and once from green, we end up with it being once in red. And it cancels out with its arrow here, like that. And we now have an equation where we have proved that what is left in red is exactly equal to what is left in green. And this is the difference of squares, because you can see that x to the power of 2 is equal to y to the power of 2 plus x plus y from these cages. And that allows you, if you can solve that equation, and you'll find out that x and y differ by exactly 1, and that allows you to solve the puzzle.
Simple.
not simple, but actually, once you start to understand Fistemafel, achievable and quite magical. And the thing I really love about this puzzle is the puzzle title was a difference of squares. And it results in a mathematical difference of squares being the equation. But that equation is derived from what we did at the start, which was to find the geometric difference of squares in the grid. So it, sort of the title is hinting at the geometry and hinting at the maths involved. It's really beautiful.
Simon, did the person who set this puzzle realize this was the way it could be solved, or was there other ways to do it?
Yeah, this was set by mathguy_12, who is a mathematician. I think that they're doing a PhD in number theory, and they wanted to set a puzzle that could explain to a layman about the difference of squares. And they achieved it in this sort of magical way. It's the first puzzle I believe they've ever set. So it's quite an incredible debut.
You couldn't solve this like people on the train by putting, does a one work there? Does a two? No.
No, I invite you to try. I don't think you could get through it. Maybe if you gave yourself 100 years and you guessed a lot, you could do it by iteration, but it wouldn't be fun.
If you haven't already seen it, I'll include a link below to our video with Simon about the mysterious Fistemafel ring. There'll also be links to Simon and his mate Mark's YouTube channel, Cracking the Cryptic. If you haven't already seen it, I think you might like it.
Take all the possible Sudoku grids and check all of them for 16 clue starting positions and to check if they give you a unique answer. That's one way to do it. It's a brute force way to do it. How many ways are there to pick 16 clues from my Sudoku grid?